Hello guys, and welcome back to Programming Made Easy. So in this video we would be talking about the job profiles in Salesforce, that what are the roles that you can apply as a Salesforce developer or in your Salesforce journey. Okay, so this video would be a bit lengthy video, because in this we would be talking about the detailed process of the job roles in Salesforce CRM, as a CRM. So let's move on with this, guys. So coming over is the first job role, that is your Salesforce Administrator. So what does a Salesforce Administrator is, or who is a Salesforce Administrator? A Salesforce Administrator is the person that provides value to the business by automating complex business processes, make sure the system is clean and efficient, and monitors new releases. Okay, essentially your Salesforce admin is the Salesforce expert within the organization, and they will have an in-depth understanding of customization. So what is the main role of Salesforce is to customize a pre-built application that has been made. So yeah, it's a profile where non-coding background people can also get accommodated with this job role. Okay, so what does a Salesforce Administrator do? So sets up new users, user maintenance, workflow rules, managing the organization wide defaults. He provides the permissions, he addresses the role hierarchy, and works with the page customization or the platform customization, like fields, layouts, etc. He also have idea of security and data management. Okay, so these are all the points that a Salesforce Administrator has to undergo. Okay, so moving over to our next profile is your Salesforce Business Analyst. So we can say that Salesforce Business Analyst is a next level up for a Salesforce Administrator. So a Salesforce Business Analyst may have experience implementing Salesforce end-to-end and possess in-depth knowledge and capabilities, as well as the limitations of the Salesforce. So basically your Salesforce Business Analyst is a somewhat a higher level as compared to, or a next level or an upgraded form that we can say. So he has a basic or in-depth understanding of the Salesforce processes, as well as the limitations that where this technology can have some loopholes or some ends. Okay, the job role of a Salesforce Business Analyst is requires gathering and analyzing business requirements. So basically he works on the business environment and converting them into effective Salesforce solutions. Okay, so that it would help to boost the revenue. Okay, moving further, that what Salesforce Analyst do is, first of all, he documents the baseline information and requirements. He develops and defines the project roadmaps, that how a particular project is to be carried out. Okay, liaising with managers and stakeholders, driving Salesforce projects forward. Okay, analyzing the Salesforce implementations, that how it is being implemented. Okay, and best practice, solving issues during testing. Okay, so this is what a business analyst do. Moving further is our Salesforce developer. So a Salesforce developer is the API integration and a code expert. Okay, so the main of aim for Salesforce developer is to create complex workflows, provide triggers, apex development, as well as complex validation rules that we cannot have using the point and click tools. So we are to write a code for this. Okay, app exchange and legacy platform integrations, etc., etc. Okay, So we can relate a Salesforce developer that he or they may have a background in other programming languages such as Java as well as other programming language, because Java has a quite similar syntax to Apex language, so that's why the persons with Java background do not face much difficulty in this domain. Okay, so what does a Salesforce developer do? So the first task is to create a complex workflows. He's the creator of triggers, Apex development of visual force pages and lightning components, integration with other systems. Okay, that how Salesforce could be integrated with other systems as well. Okay, testing as well as implementing applications, maintaining the code, maintaining the applications, installation and testing again, debugging, producing technical documentation, performing reviews of the data, as well as providing technical plans or solutions to business terms. So basically this is what your Salesforce developer do. Okay, moving further is your Salesforce platform manager. So he will perform all the duties of the Salesforce administrator role, okay, but will take more strategic view of the platform and may have the progress to leading a small team. Okay, the responsibilities for this role can be found under the Salesforce administrator title, although with some management duties thrown in. So basically what we can say is a Salesforce platform manager is a combined from your Salesforce admin plus the manager part. So this is your Salesforce platform manager. So the second type of Salesforce platform manager will be more strategic and less hands-on, okay, or if hands-on not on at all. Okay, so they will manage a large team. They often made up of multiple Salesforce administrators, developers and business analysts. So a manager as well as an admin, so we can say that what is a Salesforce platform manager. So what does he do is he is the face of the Salesforce platform to the businesses, to the customers. The overall management of the platform, collaboration with multiple teams, management of the Salesforce roadmap and plan all future platform initiatives that they are going to undertake. Okay, change management, delegation of tasks to a Salesforce team, stakeholder management, vendor management, gathering feedback, monitoring, managing bugs, fixes, okay, and prioritizing backlogs of feature requests from the business. So these are all the work or the tasks of a Salesforce platform manager. Okay, moving further guys, so we have here is your solution architect. So a solution architect is essentially responsible for designing a solution for a problem utilizing available Salesforce products and technologies, of which there are multiple within the Salesforce product suite. So who is a Salesforce solution architect? Basically designing a working on a particular problem, okay, and designing a scalable solution for that problem is the role of a Salesforce solution architect. This role builds and designs solutions across Salesforce platforms. It typically focuses on building new implementations rather than overseeing an existing one. Okay, they'll be extremely knowledgeable around the platform and usually hold a large number of certifications. So he is a very senior position person, a Salesforce solution architect. So what does he do? Project kickoff, planning, design, delivery, managing the teams to deliver the full lifecycle Salesforce implementation from inception to rollout. Okay, so he monitors the entire thing from the starting of the product development till the delivery of that. Okay, lead and manage the project team, defining a solution, working with business and IT executives from the client to identify that what are the needs of the business or what are the needs of the client, how they want, what would be the structure or defining the architecture so that it could fulfill the business needs. Okay, pre-sales and business development for new projects. Okay, resource development, making sure that projects are correctly staffed. Okay, guiding the development team through any deadlock issues, overseeing testing, making sure the solution is robust. Okay, considering the future proof of the solution, that will, can it be scalable or will it able to handle a particular problem, things like that. So last is our the Salesforce technical architect. So a Salesforce technical architect is at the highest level for a Salesforce implementation. So a Salesforce technical architect has complete expertise on the entire Salesforce platform and may be well versed with various web development languages and an expert in all the things. So we can say our technical architect has a very deep understanding about the Salesforce concept. The Salesforce architecture is a key member of the Salesforce, the Salesforce architect is a key member of the Salesforce implementation project team and is responsible for the overall technical design. So he designs, provides the design that this thing should be there. He provides an architecture to things. So the technical architect works as a team member along with the solution architect and supporting team members to deliver the complete solution for the customer. Okay, because Salesforce is a customer centric platform, so that's why. So what is his job role? So his job role is to design systems that stand up with high volumes. Security, again, security is a very important issue. So Salesforce technical architect manages the security as well, that how a security model should be laid out, considering solutions that are built for the long term, robust solutions that they need, directing integration for the systems via APIs, maintaining and overseeing governance. So maintaining the governor rules in Salesforce, you would be learning those. So these are all the job profiles that you could go for, or you could have an understanding that, because many a times we get confused that who is a Salesforce technical architect, who is a platform manager, so things like that, and how to move further. So these I have listed down these slides. I hope this video might be useful for you guys. So yeah, if it is that, so kindly give us a like and do subscribe to our channel. Yeah, thanks for watching then.